And it's better to be the part than to pretend the part. Many people are driving the car. You can see nice, beautiful clothing, jewelry, the house, and they're up to here with debt. They're playing the part. If you want to be the part, then don't just say it, take an action. Make it happen. If you say you're going to do something, take an action. If it doesn't work, fix it. If it doesn't work, do it another way. If it doesn't work, do it another way. Hi, welcome. My name is Frank Iniguez. I am the ambassador of reading. And today's topic is actions speak louder than words. So when we were going to get started with all this YouTube recording and channel, my nephew, the team, all of us, we got together, but my nephew Felix, he's like, Dio, I'm sure you're going to do great because, you know, there's so many people out there just speaking their words, but they don't really, I don't think they really know what they're talking about. How can a 22-year-old say, let me be your life coach, and he's not even married. He doesn't even know how to pay a rent or a mortgage or any of that. He's never been married, so how can he tell you about being a life coach? And he says, you know what, Dio, many times what you do, what you speak is exactly what you're doing. So you know what? When you go out there and you do your YouTube recording, I'm sure people are going to feel it across and they're going to say, you know what? This is really happening. So anyway, so I decided today's topic is actions speak louder than words. Many times when people say that they're going to create or they're going to do or they're going to have or they have, you look at their actions, you know, they're really easy to talk about. Any topic. Oh yeah, well, what about this? What about that? But when it comes down to it, their actions are not as loud. And so when I started thinking about the whole deal, I thought about a class that I teach called Mastermind. And when people come into my mastermind and I ask them, what do you want to create? They want the $100,000. They want the home. They want the trips. They want the body. And I go, okay, welcome. And I always tell them, you know, when they're in my class, I tell them, I remind them about the Karate Kid. Wax on, wax off, the easy stuff, you know? And so they come in, they're all excited. Everybody, I mean, people barely fit. And you know, I never advertised my class on the web. I mean, just most recently I've been mentioning it, but I've never said, come on over and take my class. People tell people. And it's been growing like that now for 14 years. I work with thousands of people and it gets better every time. And it's not just through me, it's through the people that help me, through the people that take the class. That leave a little change that makes it better. Anyway, so when they come in, I tell them, you know, we're gonna do a few disciplines, daily disciplines, such as drinking water. Like I said in my first video, drink water, floss your teeth, eat fiber. And there's only a total of 6 or 7 disciplines that we do, that's it. And when I tell them, okay, I want you to go buy this book, go out and get it and come back. It's very interesting how out of the 70, 80 people that show up for the class, 10 people will tell me, oh, I didn't get it on time, I didn't order it, I couldn't find it. And it's really easy for them to give me an excuse. You know, how can 60 people show up, here's the book, ready to go. But then the 10 people are not willing to do. And then I check, who bought the book? Oh, I did. Who flossed? I did. And who did their exercises or whatever it is? And it shows just around the circles because I teach my class in a circle. And you could see how people want to talk about it. People want the easy formula. People want me to just tell them how to, hey, do this, do that. And they think by me talking or by me telling them what to do, it's going to create it. That's not going to create it. Doing it, taking the action, making it happen, that's what's going to do it. So as the time goes by, I think what towards the end, middle end of the class, people realize, wow, it is up to me. If I want to create something, if I want to make something happen, it's going to be up to me. It's not going to be up to Frank. It's not going to be up to the world. It's going to be up to me to make it happen. And they realized, and I could see the difference in people. Since I've been working with thousands of people, when I say when I ask who flossed, they stand and I tell them, you know, your actions speak louder than words. You can see a healthy denture. You can see healthy teeth. You can see a healthy skin. You can see people that are doing what they're supposed to be doing. But people that are not, I mean, I can walk around the circle and I can say, wow, great action. Good. Oh, not so good. Kind of terrible. People don't realize that you can tell, but you can tell. It's very easy. If people are dehydrated, you can tell on their skin. If people are not flossing, you can tell on their dentures or their teeth. If people are not eating fruits and fibers, their energy's down. And many times it's just about doing the little things. that get you to the big things. And I always tell them, if you're going to prepare to go for that big goal, you got to be able to do the little things to get to the big things. It's like when you build a castle or you build a house. I wouldn't get in a house that doesn't have any foundation. That thing's going to come down quick. And people are forgetting to build their foundation. People are forgetting to build their home block by block and making it all the way to the top. They want to create up here with nothing holding it at the bottom. So actions speak louder than words. When I started teaching the class, I remember, I think we called it the Millionaire Club or something like that. And there, and there have been quite a few millionaires that have come through our class that were not millionaires, that are not millionaires. And I mean, no credit to me, credit to them. They did it, not me. Because if I take credit for those millionaires, I got to take credit for all the people that didn't do what they had to do. They were talking and not doing. So anyway, when I started, people would look at me and would think, wow, him? I mean, I don't know. He doesn't have a house. He doesn't have a car. But what they didn't know is that I was taking action. My action, I wanted it to speak louder than my words. I needed to build my portfolio. And I know I mentioned The Millionaire Next Door and one my other book. And millionaires, we millionaires don't show it off. When people are making it, there's no need to show it off. You just know you have it. In the book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, all the advice that he gives, he says, drive the car. I don't mind that you drive the car, but don't pay for the car. Buy an asset, let the asset pay for the liability. And so I'm thinking, if I'm reading and I'm learning, I want to do, I want to create, I want to take the action. So while people looked at me like, no, he's not it, I knew that I was becoming it. And it's better to be the part than to pretend the part. Many people are driving the car. You can see nice, beautiful clothing, jewelry, the house, and they're up to here with debt. They're playing the part. You know what? It's better to be the part. I love being the part. It's nice to have the freedom to go anywhere you want, whenever you want, with whomever you want. It's awesome to be able to do that. And actions will always speak louder than words. So finally, we read a lot of books. On the Spanish video, I mentioned Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. And I also mentioned Mr. Sharma. And he's the one that, even though I said it, he says it in his book too. His book is called The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. At the last page, he says it's the little things that create the big things. I'm paraphrasing, it's not exactly, because I also use those words too. He says, block by block, you build a castle or something like that. So for you, if you want to be the part, then don't just say it, take an action. Make it happen. If you say you're going to do something, take an action. If it doesn't work, fix it. If it doesn't work, do it. Or you can just give up and say, well, I tried, I did my best. And also, don't give the advice without doing the action. I remember when I was younger and I was learning all this stuff, I would argue with myself. I was like, well, you don't have to be a millionaire. You don't have to be a graduate. You could just tell people, well, you know what? As I get older, I realize that if I'm going to buy an apple tree, it better have some apples. You know, if I'm going to get an orange tree, it better have some oranges. In other words, if you're going to talk about it, know it. Know that it can happen. It happened for me. It's happened for a lot of people that I know. And it happened by taking an action. Do the little things to get to the big things. Don't just talk about it. Make it happen. I know that I mentioned Napoleon Hill. I mentioned The Millionaire Next Door. I mentioned Robert Kiyosaki with Rich Dad, Poor Dad. And Robin Sharma. I mean, those guys, they're talking about action. They're not talking about words. They're talking about action. Especially, I mean, I wouldn't even say especially. I love all those authors. Mr. Napoleon Hill, with everything that he did, he has inspired millions, not thousands, but millions of people. And he did it through his actions. You know what? I'm going to make it happen. He wrote a book that he hid for a long time called Outwitting the Devil. He didn't dare pull it out when he was alive. And his wife told him, don't do it. His wife didn't do it. Finally, it came out. And it's a wonderful book, and it talks about action. If you take an action, you're going to make things happen. If not, it's just going to be a whole bunch of words. When people were looking at me at the beginning of time and saying, that guy, I don't know about that guy. I mean, he says this and he says that. It's about action. It's like a lot of like my nephew said, at the beginning, how can a 22-year-old tell you about being a life coach when he hasn't even lived, not even to be married or have a house or anything like that? He says, you know what, Theo, when you, everything that you teach is because you've done it or you're doing it. And Mr. Kiyosaki said, hey, you want the car? I don't have no problem. You want the car? Get the car. But don't you pay for it. Let your assets pay for it. Wait on delayed gratification. Watch my other video on that one too. It's a pretty fun video. So if you go for it right away and you don't follow because you're not following your actions, the actions that you're supposed to follow, you're going to get sidetracked. You're going to pretend the part instead of being the part. I'd rather be the part. So yeah, it took me a little while because I was building my portfolio. I was getting my apartments and my little homes here and there. But you know what? It's fun. Once you get there, you have the freedom to go anywhere you want to go, when you want to go, with whomever you want to go. And like Robin Sharma said, you build it one block at a time. And people nowadays, they want it up here. They, just tell me. And I tell them, just do it. So if you don't do it, don't expect, you know. When people come into my mastermind, I teach them wax on, wax off. They go, hey, Frank, what's next? Have you done wax on, wax off? Well, no, I'm just waiting for the second part. Don't wait, though. Actions do speak louder than words. You got to make that, you got to put it in your head. If you don't take an action on what you're learning, it means nothing. If you're sitting down watching a video, oh, it was a good video, it means nothing. What is Frank saying? What is Sharma saying? What is Kiyosaki saying? What is Napoleon Hill saying? And you know what? Whatever they're saying, I'm sure we're saying because we did it and it works. When I was younger, I used to think, when I was barely getting into all this knowledge, I was thinking, oh, you know what? Why do we have to have the $1 million to teach? Why do we have to have a house? Why do we have to have a degree? Well, if you don't have it, how are you going to teach it? You don't know. So it feels really good once you get there, and you get there by doing the action. Actions do speak louder than words. So take an action on what you want. If it doesn't work, try it again. If it doesn't work, try it again. Do it again, do it again, do it again, do it again until it works. Or you have the other option. Sit in the corner and cry all you want and do nothing. Actions do speak louder than words. Alrighty, I hope you liked it. And you know what? I think it's time you subscribe. If you haven't, share it with your friends. Make a comment, I'll answer. Till next time, your friend, the ambassador of reading, Frank Iniguez, wishing you well today and always, knowing that you will find and get what you are looking for.